is Shashamane Entrance.
Shashamane, also known as the Promised Land, is a town in the West Arsi Zone in Oromia region in Ethiopia. Previously, we hitchhiked from Hawassa to Shashamane and we got to learn that apparently one of the first people to return to Shashamane, Papa Noel Dyer, had hitchhiked from England to Ethiopia, which I think is fascinating. Apart from that, we quickly learned that Shashamane is not just about the Rastafarians, but has more inclusion that we will get into as we continue in this video. Shashamane is not only about the 500 acres that was gifted to African Americans, but has a bigger land that many Ethiopians live a normal Ethiopian life. Being able to see all regions accepted and practiced in one town was a great sign of acceptance and togetherness, where 40% are of the Orthodox Christianity, 30% Muslim, and the other percentage of all other religions.
These are the longest dreadlocks I have seen with a lady. And also I got to learn you should not ask people the height of their dreadlocks, but just look at that.
Today we focus on why this land is believed to be a promised land and is important to you and I.
Sorry.
Hard disk.
Like it broke.
No, it's not broken.
You don't know this something, yes,
sir.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
I'm not sure.
DJ, you know?
Thus, we visit one of an organization that is in charge of Ethiopian World Federation to help us understand more about this.
Organization. Mm-hmm. So what happens here?
It is an organization that was started in 1937 by Dr. Malapu Bayana.
Okay.
He's relative to Haile Selassie.
Ah.
And 1937 he is in America. Mm-hmm. They start this organization to help Ethiopia. Because at that time Ethiopia is being attacked by Italy.
Yeah.
You know, so this is organization come about to help Ethiopia. And as a result of our aid for Ethiopia, the government of Ethiopia, Haile Selassie government, they give 5 gashas of land in Shashamane. So that is the history around Shashamane. They say Jamaica and Shashamane because of the work that we do to aid Ethiopia. So now we are here and we are registered and we are here in Ethiopia now. Ethiopia is still at war. So we are making program and development aid that we can aid Ethiopia.
So is here the main the land that is the place in Shashamane that was given by Haile Selassie?
Well, it was both sides of the road.
Both sides of the road.
Yeah. But after communism, 1974, they take away most of the land. Yes, so it's only few people who remain here of that land. Also, someone's come and they, newcomers, they come and they help the people who are here and they get land also. Okay. So that is the history.
But the whole Shashamane is blessed, right?
Because the whole of Ethiopia. Ethiopia is the only part on the African continent that was not colonized. So the whole of Ethiopia is blessed. Also, it is where Solomon and Sheba, the Ark of the Covenant, it rests now in Ethiopia. Ethiopia is blessed. For the Rastaman. And for the black peoples of the West, Shashamane is blessed because it is the only place that we have that we can call was given to us by His Imperial Majesty.
Haile Selassie.
But wherever you find the blessing, you're going to always find fighting.
Oh, okay.
Because righteousness is light. And the light will fight against the darkness. You always saw the light must prevail. So It is forces, good and evil.
Mm-hmm.
You find good, you see evil coming along.
Yeah. And the darkness will be bright.
Yeah.
Of course, wherever the good and the righteousness is light.
So does that explain why there is always war in Ethiopia?
Well,
at some point,
not always,
but like after this war, we stay with peace for some time, and then this other one.
But that's the hurt. The whole world is like that.
Yeah.
Because mankind, they don't know themselves.
Okay.
They always want more power.
Mm-hmm.
They want more to see. They see Ethiopia,
mm-hmm.
and they want Ethiopia to become Italian.
Yeah.
You see, so yeah. That is why mankind is always in war. South Africa is the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's the Europeans and the other nations. They come and they see what the black man have,
mm-hmm.
and they want to take it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so yeah. That is the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Until mankind know peace.
Yeah.
And pursue it,
mm-hmm.
there will always be war.
Yeah.
But His Majesty, He knows the way, is the father of African unity.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, yeah, so they fight against Him, but He still conquered. So they could never conquer Ethiopia because it is written in the Bible.
Okay.
It is ordained for Ethiopia to stretch forth her hands and hearts unto God Almighty.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it is a blessed country. It is mentioned the very first book in the Bible.
Genesis?
It speaks about Ethiopia and the river that runs through the whole land of Ethiopia.
River.
The Nile.
Nile.
Yes.
Yeah.
The Blue Nile.
Yeah.
And it waters Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Without it, Egypt will starve and suffer. And yet they make war on Ethiopia. They want to fight Ethiopia because Ethiopia wants to harness her power with the water of the Nile.
Mm-hmm.
And it still will benefit Egypt and Sudan.
Yeah.
And Sudan, they make war and they says, well, they don't want it. And then they get flooded with many water.
Yeah.
And now they are in war. So Ethiopia have the mystic powers, which is preventing any colonial force from taking over.
Mm.
The only problem now is the internal tribe to tribe. That is the problem. That is, whenever the foreign people see that, they use that to get in and disturb Ethiopia.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to, as Rasta and as the Ethiopian World Federation, we promote oneness. Together we are strong. United, we are strong. If we are divided amongst ourselves, we will surely fall.
Yeah.
His Majesty says, avoid the pitfalls of tribalism.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't worry about tribe. From you are black, you are one. We are Ethiopians. So we have to promote that. And then there will be peace.
Yeah.
But if you start to promote one tribe, a different tribe, over the years, that is the problem. Mm-hmm. Right now we are one tribe.
Yeah.
When they see Ethiopia, they want to colonize and have all of us together as one. So why are we going to fight now to say we are 2, 3, 4, 85 different tribes? No, we are one. We are black. We are Kush. So that is the main thing. That is what we promote. So we include all. We get discriminated. We are black.
Mm-hmm.
And we was taken from Africa to the West.
Yeah.
And yet when we come back to Ethiopia, we get persecute, we get discriminated against to say we are foreign G.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it is not our will. Our will is that while we was there, we defend Ethiopia.
Mm-hmm.
Because we fight for Ethiopia to maintain her independence, her sovereignty.
Yeah.
You know, so His Majesty come to Jamaica 1966,
mm-hmm.
and he says the Ethiopian,
mm-hmm.
the Jamaicans are one. So we are one. Whether we like it or not, we are one.
Are you Jamaican or Ethiopian?
I'm Ethiopian.
Oh, you're Ethiopian.
I'm Ethiopian. Nice. Jamaican was by slavery.
Yeah.
Our parents were taken from Africa and went to Jamaica by force, by chains around our neck, our hands and our feet.
Mm-hmm.
We was forced to work in Jamaica. But when that, after my parents, they go to England, we born in England and we come back to Ethiopia.
Ethiopia.
So we return home.
Mm-hmm.
So we are the one slave descendants who was taken from Africa to the Caribbean, from the Caribbean to England, from England, Africa.
Africa.
So we complete the triangle.
Wow.
Yes, and we come home.
Amazing.
So all we want now is for us to realize who is the real enemy.
Mm-hmm.
It is not black against black.
Yeah.
The real enemy is those who are up in the high places, these government, these governments who are giving you IMF, International Monetary Funding. When they give you this money, they tell you, you must do this, you must do that. And if you don't do it, they stop the money.
Yeah.
So we don't need this money. And all this money, it is the wealth of Africa, what they steal. They, the Europeans, they come here, they steal all the wealth of Africa. You know how much wealth they have of Ethiopia when Theodorus, King Theodorus, they come to fight against him. So he kill himself. And they loot all the wealth from the churches in Lalibela and Oxum and all these places. They loot and they have it now in the British Museum. In there to say that is their history. Yet it is Ethiopia's heritage. So all these things, don't, they are the real enemy. So that is where the fight is. We should be uniting with the people so that we can make Ethiopia a better place for us to live, and black people in general, the example of the herd, because that is what it is. The world needs example of how to live in love, and Ethiopia is the first kingdom on the earth. So it cradles all civilization in Ethiopia. So now we just have to know our history and our roots and establish it in the whole world, because the world needs peace and they cannot find it. But it is all here, the Ark of the Covenant. That means the solution for mankind's problem is here. But we have to look within our ourselves and know the true purpose of why the Father, he created us. You know, so we are here promoting these things.
Wow. Amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Together.
We later got a breakdown of how this organization helps African Americans, Jamaicans and Rastafarians to gain their nationality here in Ethiopia. For more details, you can leave me a comment down below. Let's have a conversation. What are your opinion on Rastafarian, Shashamane and all this lifestyle here in Ethiopia? Do you think this is a very, very important land for us here in Ethiopia? Let me know in the comment section below. Now that you fully understood about the town Shashamane and where this whole history came from and why this land is important, stay tuned for the next episode as I'm gonna be taking you through the Rastafarian traditions and all their beliefs and everything they're gonna be going through. Always, always remember to create time for that which ignites your soul. Until next time, bye for now.